Monopolistic competition, Chamberlin's approach, part 2, short-run equilibrium of a firm. This is part 2 of this series. If you didn't view part 1, please listen to it first. I have given the link in the description. Okay, we shall start our discussion from where we have stopped in part 1. Can a firm operate along the perceived demand curve as it wishes? Why Chamberlin uses proportional demand curve and perceived demand curve in his analysis? Yes, a firm can operate along the perceived demand curve, but it cannot operate only on the perceived demand curve, totally ignoring the proportional demand curve. Why? The following numerical example will help you to understand this. We shall start from point A on the proportional demand curve. A firm is operating at point A. It sells 400 units at 8 rupees. If the firm slides down to point C along the proportional demand curve by reducing its price to 6 rupees, it can sell 450 units. Instead, it develops perceived demand curve DD. It is more elastic than the proportional demand curve. It slides down to point B along the perceived demand curve and sells 600 units at the same price, 6 rupees. It sells more. Point B is not on the proportional demand curve. It is on the perceived demand curve. The firm thinks that it alone has improved the sales by reducing the price with a great success. The firm is right. Since there are a large number of firms, reducing the price by a single firm doesn't adversely affect the sale of other firms. So, other firms didn't take any notice of price reduction by a single firm. But the thing is, the same thought occurs to each firm individually and independent of others. Each firm is reducing the price in order to sell more, without understanding the fact the other firms are also doing the same. They are all at point B on their respective perceived demand curves. You must understand, it is not an act of retaliation by firms, but an original planning according to each firm. But at this price, the market is willing to take only 450 units from each firm and not 600 units. Unable to sell 600 units, each firm moves to point C on the proportional demand curve. Each firm sells only 450 units. The firms are back on their respective proportional demand curves. The point to understand here is, 1. Each firm would like to expand its sales by sliding down along the perceived demand curve. But when all the firms do the same, their very action pushed them back to the proportional demand curve. 2. Finally, they will be operating along the proportional demand curve. With this basic understanding, we shall proceed to discuss the short-run equilibrium of a firm. A firm has to satisfy three conditions to be in short-run equilibrium. 1. Marginal cost must be equal to marginal revenue. 2. Marginal cost must be increasing at the point of equilibrium, or MC curve must cut the MR curve from below. 3. Proportional demand must be equal to perceived demand. To earn supernormal profit, firm has to satisfy one condition. When the firm is in equilibrium, its average revenue must be greater than average cost. Well, look at this graph. D is the perceived demand curve of the firm. It is the same as average revenue curve. Its corresponding marginal revenue curve is MR. D is the proportional demand curve. Marginal cost and average cost are represented by MC and AC curves. E is the point of equilibrium. At this point, marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue. Marginal cost is increasing. Marginal cost curve cuts the marginal revenue curve from below. The first two conditions are satisfied. Move directly down from point E towards x-axis. M is the equilibrium output. Move vertically up from point E. At point F, proportional demand curve cuts the perceived demand curve. Proportional demand is equal to perceived demand. The third equilibrium condition is also satisfied. When the firm produces M units of output, all the three equilibrium conditions are satisfied. Hence, the firm is in short-run equilibrium. Examine the average cost and average revenue. Its average revenue is MF. Its average cost is MG. MF is greater than MG. Average revenue is greater than average cost. The firm's supernormal profit condition is also satisfied. Firm's total revenue is average revenue times output. OM multiplied by OP. Area OPFM represents total revenue. Total cost is average cost times output. OM multiplied by OH. Area OHGM represents total cost. Supernormal profit is total revenue minus total cost. OPFM minus OHGM. Area PFGH represents abnormal profit. Chamberlin assumes that all the firms have the same cost condition. From this we can understand all the firms in the group are in short-run equilibrium enjoying abnormal profit. This is in brief the short-run equilibrium of a firm under monopolistic competition. In the upcoming videos, we shall discuss the three models of long-run equilibrium in parts 3, 4, and 5. We shall meet again.